Yep. So, can I offer you an umbra cola?
Is it warm?
It is
warm.
Then please do pour.
Oh, yes. So, in this video, we're going to talk about the Umbrago Cold Garden Retreat.
Yes.
Many people don't know what the retreat is, or the Cold Garden Retreat is. So, maybe, Pierre, you could start?
About the Cold Garden Retreat?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is it?
What is it? Oh, it's... For how long have you been doing the retreats?
10 years-ish.
Yeah. So, so the retreat happens every year before Cold Garden for 3 days, where we gather the most important people in the community, along with HQ people. And it's people we select based on the people we find that can give the project value. And give us new insights, new input about where the project should go, and give us valuable feedback on what we've been doing the past year. So it also helps us set the direction for the next year. So the retreats has traditionally been a retreat to a summer house, where a bunch of guys sit down and code various things, hack together things, or some years we just sit down and talk about things and into what direction we should go. So one of the most well-known retreats was the one where we decided to cancel version 5.
Yep, that's an example.
It's not the best one, but it's also, it tells us about where some of the more important decisions about the project is made.
Yep, true. So you could say the Cold Garden Retreat is where the HQ gets in sync with the community around core functionality. And Rune, you've been to a couple of retreats.
Yeah, two I think.
How would you describe the retreat?
But it's a way of kind of pooling the resources of the HQ and the MVPs of the Umbrago community, the marginally viable people or something like that. And for the ones I've been at, the first one, it was mainly road mapping for the next year. So what should the HQ be focusing on? And the second one, we tried to kind of have more defined tasks, working on specifically version 7.6 of Umbrago. But we've been working on a ton of things, like the new documentation structure for OWL, for example, was the outcome of a retreat.
That was the first one you were
on? Yeah, that was the first one I was at. We've been working on the new template, which the last one I was on, and so kind of different things, trying to make use of the different resources that are at the retreat.
Yep. So this year we're actually going to try to do it a little bit different. We're not going to go in a country house.
Yep.
We're starting at the HQ and then we're moving to some boutique hotel. So it's feels less of a stag party. Some would say that's about time. And then one thing that's also different is we are trying to make the retreat less mysterious. So for the Cold Garden program, it will actually be effective.
Yeah, so the retreat will have an official session at Cold Garden this year. So it's to tell everybody what we've been doing at the retreat. So it's not like a closed circle of people who only knows about the secret things going on at Cold Garden, or at the retreat. It's also about, here's the decisions we made, here's what we're going to do forward, and this is some of the samples of work that we've been doing.
Yeah, and hopefully here's how you can contribute.
Yep.
So the retreat gets less of this closed, fancy, invite-only membership thing, and more where the purpose is that how can we inspire even more people to contribute.
Yeah. It's not a country club, it is meant to be a starting point of new work for the next year.
And having that session also means that people might actually know what we mean when we say the retreat, because it's just a word we've been saying for a couple of years, and some people know what it is and a lot of people have no idea what it is.
So even if you're not at Cold Garden, you'll actually see the video of the retreat output afterwards, and you can actually see areas of the community and then the project where you can get involved.
Perfect.
I think that sounds awesome.
I can't wait. Cheers.
Bottoms up.
It's better as a rum Dracula.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's more.